Well, Gidarjil, like most organisations, always start because they see a need in the community.
Well, it's like no other. The drone trap program for us elders is that we've never been able to experience any of that underwater, seeing things underneath. We've only been able to surmise what's under there. It's like we're walking on country. Before, we always had to learn by stories being handed down to us. Now we'll be able to enjoy all of this with our young people. They'll be able to beam that information to us wherever we are. But the great thing about it all is that it's our people that are doing it. Our Aboriginal rangers, our sea rangers and land rangers. The knowledge that they've picked up, they would never been able to do this if it hadn't been for this program.
This proof of concept is part of the 5G innovation grant, and what we're doing is we're taking footage from undersea drones and aerial drones and being able to broadcast them via high definition video to remote locations. By utilising 5G, we're able to get high definition video that that shows a crystal clear picture to the end receiver, so they don't need to physically be at a location. What our end goal is to enable the elders to be able to remotely operate these drones themselves, so they can actually go and have a look at different things that they see of cultural significance to them.
From a Mobile Corp and Cradlepoint point of view, success is being able to get a solid signal from 5G towers and be able to utilise that with the underwater and aerial drones to live stream footage. For the entire project, we're utilising three W2005 routers. Today we're using one here at Cairns and one in Bagara and transmitting to elders in a third location. The benefits of using 5G over 4G is clearly the speed. Today we were able to get over 350 megabits down and over 80 megabits up, ensuring that we could get the highest quality live stream signal back to the elders.
The program will benefit the rangers mapping 26,000 kilometres of sea country and 20,000 of kilometres of square kilometres of land country, looking for cultural heritage sites, identifying cultural significant sites both on country and in water.
So this 5G initiative project for the underwater drones has enabled our drones to have more capability and use in the environment. And I'll be able to see more of my country.
The benefits are, we see it as environmentally, commercially, and also to develop further our business around our drone, because we've also registered as a National Indigenous Drone Training Centre with our training organisation, and also not only create the jobs and the training, but also it'll help us with our elders in capturing the traditional knowledge through a database. In Gidarjil, we've always incorporated professionals around the Western science, but they will tell you as well they can't do it without the traditional knowledge. So this 5G grant will help us combine the traditional knowledge for over the thousands of years that we've been here and work on cutting edge with Western science and combine the two to get more sustainable outcomes, not only for First Nations people, but for the whole community.
With the elders and with our young people, we'll all have to learn it all together again. So that's what is going to be great about this 5G program.